So the YouTuber Shadiversity, otherwise known as Shad, recently made a video about the hidden blade from Assassin's Creed. And I'm not a hardcore Assassin's Creed fan, but I do think he got some things wrong. He got a lot of stuff right though. They're not terribly useful weapons. I think there are some aspects where they could actually be kind of useful that like Shad didn't cover. There's also some things about the games and some errors I want to correct while I'm here. Okay, so just before I get into it, I don't hate Shad. I'm not making this to hate on Shad. I'm more making it to like not spread misinformation, which I know Shad is all about. So in that regard, it should be pretty good. Okay, so first off, the whole cutting the ring finger off, that's not something they had to do on the earlier versions. They did it more to sort of secure, so they wouldn't like it wouldn't eject on their finger and they would have to lose a lot of blood or something. Like, they did it either for safety or for the whole tradition. Because as we see in Assassin's Creed Origins, Bayek, the main character in that game, he accidentally gets his finger off when he's like in a fist fight and he's having his hand like this. Then the blade comes up like this and cuts his finger off. And after that, he loses his ring finger, and after that, people start, when he makes a creed, people start doing it themselves to sort of honor him or tradition, or just to be safe. Okay, so one of the first things that Shadiversity mentions is the sort of how hard it is to get to people, because he uses a really long blade, basically like this. This isn't a blade, obviously. But it's basically as long that his hand can't like reach over it. So then we see him trying to like stab with it and stuff, and it's really hard when you have it this long. And as we see in the games, they usually have it a lot shorter, which of course lets you like get like the point. You can move the point easier and get it to your target easier. But as Shad says, the dagger can be pretty stealthy. You can just go up to somebody and just stab them like this. And it is pretty easy to be stealthy with this. But a shorter blade would be even easier. I mean, he doesn't really say anything about how long the dagger has to be, but the blades are too long, according to the games. But I feel like an advantage that the hidden blade has, which is a switch blade I have attached with like rubber bands here, a thing that he didn't consider is that when you have a blade that this short and it comes out like this from your wrist, it can actually be kind of well hidden by your hand. Like when I'm standing like this, you can't see the blade at all. I mean, the assassins from the game probably have like a little bit longer than this. It depends on the game. But if you have it like this, the fingers basically hide it. And then if you stab someone, it basically looks like you're just tapping them. So like we see in the games always that the assassins are like walking. They're like walking around like tapping people and stuff and pushing them out of the way. And like, if you do that, if you like tap people and then suddenly there's like a stab there, or like a slow stab, so it's like more silent, it basically blends in with the pushes. And I think that's a pretty good way for like having it be hidden. Like, you can't do that with a dagger. Because with a dagger, you can't really push with your hand because you're holding it like this. And it's not really easy to get stabbed with this and conceal it at the same time. So I think that's an advantage. One thing to also mention that I don't think Shadiversity knows about the games is that you have the high profile, low profile system. So like when you're holding the running button, your character does like a drastic like move to do the thing you're supposed to do. And that's the best move most of the time, or the most badass move in the game. But if you're not pressing that, they usually do like a little stab, or like a very concealed stab. And also the thing about the assassins being trained with this weapon. I know that he says that just shouldn't really matter, but we can see a lot that in these higher profile moves, for example, they can do stuff like throws it. And they usually get underneath the armor with like, can't see that on the camera, but like if there's like a under the chest plates, for example, they usually stab around the waist. Also, just a point I would like to mention, the fact that they talk about the blade detaching, like rotating and then hinging off. Only Connor from Assassin's Creed 3 can do that, because he's hunting and stuff, and we see him like detach it to like skin animals and and stuff. He also used it a little bit in combat, if you use the hidden blades for combat, but that's about it, and he's the only one that does it. Okay, so the mechanism of the blade. I agreed that the whole spring system would be really hard for the time. I don't really know that much about materials from very ancient times. Like, we see the hidden blade even in ancient Egypt, and I don't know how the hell they had springs there. Or I guess you could use some kind of rubber. I have like this. This doesn't work right now, but this is a switchblade that is 3D printed. Supposed to work, but the rubber band inside here has like broken, so. But that works, just an elastic material. And then we also come to the point Shad says that it would be hard for the weapon, that you wouldn't be able to retract the weapon. Even though right here we have a switchblade, uses one spring, and it can, it's a little hard. It can come out and come in, just whenever it wants. I mean, they don't work 100% of the time, and I doubt this would be easy to make at all with like old materials. Another thing that I don't think Shad actually considered, or knew about, I mean, is the fact that when they stab with the blades in Assassin's Creed, they don't stab with the force of the spring. Like in Assassin's Creed Unity, they have the crossbow thing here, but that's its own separate thing, because in that game they have their hidden blade on this hand, I believe, the left hand, and then they have the crossbow thing on the other hand, and they shoot that like a crossbow. But they still have the regular old blade. There's actually not a canon way of them actually ejecting the blade. Because the whole climbing thing, it would really be a problem, because the assassins are always parkouring all over the place. And, like, you would have to grab this and grab that. And if your hand, when you did this, for example, got the blade out, then it would probably like come at really inconvenient times when you're like trying to reach for something or grab something. Actually, the whole mechanism would, I do believe it should be pretty controllable, because we see actually in Assassin's Creed Revelations 2, when Ezio is like old, so he can't reach the taller places, he has like his own, that one is a little longer, but like the hook blade, so he can like hook onto things and drag himself up. I don't think he drags himself up with the spring, like it gets pushed up when it goes in. That's not possible, but I think he like hooks up. Okay, that's basically it for my response to Shadiversity. I mean, I'm not a HEMA channel or anything. I do a lot of different stuff. You can go check it out if you want. I don't know if you like it, but that's for you to find out. But I just wanted to not spread the misinformation and make sure Shad gets it right. So this is not anything against Shad. I love Shad. I have his chainmail t-shirt. I don't have it with me right now, sadly. But I'm gonna read his book someday. I'm a huge fan. So just continue what you're doing, Shad. Just make sure to research or ask someone like professional. I mean, you are quite the professional yourself, but if you're reviewing like a game, you should probably ask someone who knows a lot about the game and see what they have. Because they may have a bit of fanboyitis or bias, but that doesn't mean that their things can't be like put into consideration. But yeah, that's it, so goodbye. I'll see you in the next one. I don't know when or what, but we'll see. Goodbye.